Dear students, this is again steam nozzle problem, part 3. Example 4.8. Tri-saturated steam at the 7 bar is passed through a convergent divergent nozzle. The throat cross-sectional area is 4.5 cm square. Find the mass flow rate per minute through the nozzle. So given data P1 equal to 7 bar. And dry saturated steam A2 equal to 4.5 cm square. So at a P1 equal to 7 bar dry saturated condition, V1 equal to 0.27268 meter cube per kilogram, and for dry saturated steam N equal to polytropic index N equal to 1.135. And the maximum discharge per unit area, equation for maximum discharge per unit area, M by A maximum equal to square root of 2N by N plus 1 P1 by V1 into 2 by N plus 1 to the power 2 by N minus 1. So substituting 2 into 1.135 divided by 1.135 plus 1 into 7 into 10 power 5 divided by 0.27268 into 2 by 1.135 plus 1 to the power 2 by N minus 1. So that gives 1018.85. So the mass flow rate M equal to 1018.85 into 4.5 into 10 power minus 4. So for the area given is 4.5 centimeter square. Now multiplying by 10 power 4, we are converting into meter square. So that is equal to 0.458 kilograms per second. The answer is converting, dividing by 60, multiplying by 60, this is 27.48 kilograms per minute. So the mass flow rate answer is 27.48 kilograms per second. Next problem, example 4.9. The steam enters at 30 bar and 300 degrees Celsius and flows at a rate of 14 kilograms per second. After expansion to a exit pressure of 5 bar, the exit velocity is 800 meters per second. Determine nozzle efficiency in the exit area. If loss occurs only in the divergent portion, determine velocity of the steam at the throat section. The initial condition is P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius. Mass flow rate is 14 kilograms per second. Exit condition is P3 equal to 5 bar and V3 equal to 800 meters per second. And for the given initial condition, P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius. Enthalpy, from the enthalpy of superheated steam, table number 4, it is 2995.1 kilojoules per kilogram, and S1 equal to 6.542 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And exit condition, HF3 5 bar pressure, HF3 640.1 kilojoules per kilogram, SFG equal to 2107.4 kilojoules per kilogram, and SF3 equal to 1.86 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, SFG equal to 4.959 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and VG3 equal to 0.37466 meter cube per kilogram. For isentropic flow, we know entropy is constant, S1 equal to S3, that equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. Substituting for S1, SF3 and SFG3, we will get X3 equal to 0.94. And the enthalpy of the steam at the exit, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3. Substitute and calculate, it is 2621 kilojoules per kilogram. Velocity at the outlet, this is given. Velocity at the outlet is given, 800 meters per second. So that is equal to 2000 into H1 minus H3 into nozzle efficiency. So you calculate, substitute and calculate, nozzle efficiency is 0.855 or 85.5 meters per, sorry, 85.5%. The specific quality of the steam at exit, X3 equal to V3 equal to X3 into VG3, that is equal to 0.3522 meter cube per kilogram. So the exit area equal to, mass flow rate is again given as 14 kilograms per second. So A3 into velocity is 800 meters per second, specific quality is 0.3522. So the area is 6.16 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. And for superheated steam, N equal to 1.3, the throat pressure is P2 equal to P1 into 2 by N plus 1 to the power N by N minus 1, that is equal to 30 into 2 by 1.3 plus 1 to the power 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1 equal to 16.4 bar. And look at the steam table. So we have data for 16 bar and 16.5 bar. So we take the data is G, H, S, G and D, S, and they interpolate for 16.4 bar. So this is the property of the steam. Now I assume superheated steam at the throat section. So S1 equal to S2 equal to Sg2 plus Cp into logarithmic of T2 by Ts2. So substituting the values, so temperature equal to 228.3 degrees Celsius. So the temperature of the superheated steam at the throat section is 228.3 degree Celsius. So it is superheated steam at the throat section. So enthalpy equal to H2 equal to Hg2 plus Cp into T2 minus Ts2. So substituting, you will get 2845.97 kilojoules per kilogram. So enthalpy at the throat section. Now the velocity is V2 equal to square root of 2000 into H1 minus H2. Substituting for H1 and H2, it is equal to 546.1 meters per second. The answers are nozzle efficiency is 85.5, exit area is 61.6 centimeter square, and velocity of the steam at the throat section equal to 546.1 meters per second. Now take another problem, problem number 10, example number 10. Steam at a pressure of 10 bar and 0.9 dry discharges through a nozzle having throat area 650 millimeter square. If the back pressure is 1.4 bar, find the final velocity of the steam, cross section area of the nozzle at exit for maximum discharge. Inlet condition is dry, wet steam now. Inlet condition is P1 equal to 10 bar and X1 equal to 0.9. And the throat area is 350 into 10 power minus 6 meter square, and exit pressure is 1.4 bar. So from this steam table at 10 bar, table number 2, HF1, HFG1, SF1 and SFG1, VG1, you have to take all the value from the steam table. Calculate the enthalpy HF1 plus X1 HFG1. So 2574.84 kilojoules per kilogram. S1 equal to SF1 plus X1 SFG1, 6.1385 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and V1 equal to X1 into VG1, 0.9 into 0.1943 equal to 0.17487, and this is meter cube per kilogram. And for wet steam, N equal to 1.035 plus 0.1X1 is equal to 1. So this equation you have to remember. So for this wet steam, polytropic index equal to 1.035 plus 0.1X1, this is 1.125. So for maximum mass flow rate, M by A maximum equal to 2 by N plus 1 P1 by V1 into 2 by N plus 1 to the power 2 by N minus 1. So substituting, M by A maximum equal to 1515. So the mass flow rate at the throat section equal to 0.53 kilograms per second. So at the exit pressure, HF3 equal to exit pressure P3 equal to 1.4 bar. So HF3, HFG3, SF3, SFG3 and VG3, all these data from the steam table, from table number 2 for P3 equal to 1.44 bar. 1.4 bar, this value. Okay. Now, exit condition of the steam, S1 equal to S3 equal to SF3 again, SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. So substituting, you will get X3 equal to 0.81. So enthalpy at the outlet. So 66.24 kilojoules per kilogram, specific volume at the outlet 1 meter cube per kilogram. So velocity at the exit of the steam nozzle, V3 equal to 2000 into H1 minus H3. So 2000 into 2574.84 minus 2266.24, that is equal to 785.6 meters per second. And exit area of the nozzle, A3 equal to M into specific volume divided by velocity V3. 0.53 into 1 divided by 785.6 equal to 6.74 10 power minus 4 meter square. So the answers are final velocity of the steam V3 equal to 785.6 meters per second, and the exit area of the nozzle A3 equal to 6.74 centimeter square.